What's up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel, Hooked Up with Levi. We are here on another fishing trip. Today we decided to come up to Silver Lake Flat, just right above Table Fork Reservoir. Today we got with us Brian, we got little Soraya, and we got Tiffany. So I brought my fly rod up here also today. I'm gonna give that a try. It'll be my first time, so, well, like my third time, but it's been years, so let's see what we can do. All right, you guys, we'll see you guys. All right, you guys, so this is the fly rod I've got. It's an Orvis Clearwater, and I've got an Okuma SLV 5.6, and this is a 8.5 foot rod, 5 weight. So I'm gonna be using this today. I just wanna give a shout out to Juan for giving this to me. Thank you, Juan, I appreciate it. And we're gonna go through our flies and I'll show you what I'm gonna tie on. All right, you guys. So I've got this dry fly tied on. Like I said, I've never dry fly fished before. I fished like 3 times before in my life. And I've only done it on the Provo River with a buddy and his dad. And it was just trying to teach me how to roll cast down a stream. So I've never dry fly fished. So this will be the first time. So let's give it a shot. I think I want to be out further. Oh man. Nope, I need to see you guys. Told you I've never done this. So I'm gonna have a hard time knowing what I'm doing. I got too much line out. That's my problem. There we go, that was a better cast. All right, you guys, I already lost my dry fly because I don't know what I'm doing, like I said. So I got a little strike indicator on, and I've got a little nymph, a little sinker. So hopefully I can catch something. Thank you. I am really not good at this, you guys. Lost it already, guys. All right, you know what, you guys? I'm gonna stop fly fishing. I'm gonna go grab my spinner rod. All right, you guys. So I know I gave up really easy, really fast on the fly fishing. I need to give it some more practice before I go and try to do it on film ever again, so I don't look like a total jackass. So anyways, I'm gonna be giving it some practice, and hopefully in the future you'll see me fly fishing on camera. All right, you guys, I got my regular little setup that I like, my Carolina rig to 6 pound test. This time I got a little bit longer leader, so it floats a little bit higher. So I got some pink power bait on, and then I've got my ugly stick, 7 foot, ultra light action with my same RC40 reel like always. So I'm gonna give it a cast and see if I can get hooked up. All right, guys, getting a bite. Got one, first fish. Hooked up. Wonder what it is. Looks like a rainbow trout. Yeah, it's a little rainbow trout. Oh, actually good size rainbow trout. Out of here, they don't get that much bigger out here, so let's get them unhooked. We plan on keeping some. So all right, you guys, worked the first time. Let's see if it works again. I got the bright pink power bait on. Oh, there's a bite. Hooked up, guys. Really hoping to catch a grayling today. But nope, just a small trout. Small little rainbow. Oh, don't get caught up in that. Yeah, just a small rainbow. All right, you guys, in case if you guys are new to the channel and haven't seen the way that I hook up my power bait, I'm gonna show you guys how. You're just gonna grab just a little bit. You don't need a lot of power bait. A lot of people think you need tons of power bait, but you don't. I like to use a size 16 treble hook. So you're gonna grab your power bait, you're gonna smash it on your size 16 treble hook, put it in between your thumb, your pointer finger, let it hang like that. You're gonna give it a little roll in the palm of your hands, give it a little tail just like that, and that lets the fish think it's a minnow. The dying minnow. If you're not getting a hit, you want to reel it. It'll swim down, and then when you stop reeling, then it'll float back up. That attracts a lot of fish that way. That's how I have been fishing for years, and I've always had success. All right, you guys, I'm gonna try this chartreuse green. It's not really chartreuse green. It's like a baby Yoda green power bait. You just give that a little twist in your hand. Give it a little tail. Just like that. All right, give this one a try, guys. I like to dip it in the water so it don't come off the hook as you're casting. All right. Here's my beautiful little girl, my wife. You got Brian over there. He's still over there fly fishing. He hasn't given it up quite as easy as I have. Oh, I'm getting a bite, guys. Hooked up. Maybe. Maybe he got off. Or maybe he's... No, he's not off. Just a small fish. He's fighting like those trout. Yep, another little trout. Alright, Tiffany's hooked up. See what it is. Come over here so it don't get caught in that. Never mind. Just bring him over there just so you don't get caught up in the stringer. It's a nice little rainbow trout. It's a good size. That's a good size. That's bigger than mine that I caught. We'll keep that one.
Okay.
Good job, honey.
Your turn next, Soraya.
All right, you guys, got my Jake's lure on. See if we can get any action with that.
You put the whole pack in. For her, we usually do half, but she does the whole one. But I got your other little...
Let it sink a little bit so it's not just swimming on the top.
Okay, Soraya, it is dead. You happy now?
Yes.
Maybe kill a poor ant.
Not poor.
Okay, I'm gonna cast this out for you, or do you want to try casting it yourself?
I don't think it's the pole, I think it's the caster.
I didn't have a problem casting.
All right, you guys, nothing so far on the Jake's lure. I'm gonna go back to the good old power bait and a treble hook. So
Don't want to face plant it.
Soraya, hold your tip out. Soraya, now reel it in tight. So your line is tight and you got to hold your pole still and just concentrate. Unless you want me to get you a pole holder so you can just set it down.
She did say that. She goes, I sure wish I had a pole holder.
Okay, well, I have a pole holder. We'll get you a pole holder. Alright, you guys, brought one of my other poles down from my truck. It's my little mini rod, my little 4.5 foot rod. Got it hooked up to a worm hook and a worm Carolina rig still. Alright, let's go give this a cast. Alright. So far, nothing on this worm.
I think they like power bait more.
I know, I just want to catch a grayling.
Oh, do they like the worms?
Yeah. Graylings go for more like bugs and worms.
Okay.
At least in my experience.
That's what I caught that one on was a worm.
That's what you caught that grayling on last week was a worm?
Still got
it. Alright, Soraya's hooked up.
Again?
It's her second fish. Ooh. Don't pull your rod so high up. Just keep it out in front of you.
Just
another tiny one. Reel him over here quick so he doesn't get in that line. Come over here then. Oh, you got him.
That's a pretty butterfly. Oh.
Good job, Soraya.
Good job.
Oh, he just looked little in the water. He's not as small as that other one.
Oh, yeah.
Want to keep him?
Yeah.
There you go, sweetheart.
Ooh. That doesn't sound very fun.
All right. So I've caught three, Soraya's caught two, Tiff's caught one. Waiting for Brian to get on the board.
Maybe our spot is better than
this. All right, guys. All right, you guys. I'm using the power bait again. Wasn't getting anything on the worms. Not even a bite. So oh, there's a little bite.
You just got a little bite?
Just a little one. All right, guys, hooked up. It's the fourth fish. Already getting a hit. That's right, you went over my line. It's okay, sweetie. Oh, that was you. I thought I was getting a bite, you guys. That was right over my line. No, don't do it like that. Go up to it and pull it off.
Gosh.
Actually, you guys, I didn't think I had one because Soraya was hooked up to my line, but I do have one. All right, fish number 5. Alright, you guys, it's another fish. We're gonna keep this one, it's a good size. Alright guys, hooked up. This one looks like a decent size. No, he's just bright colored. He's small. All right, you guys, believe it or not, there's fish number 9 for me. So we're just gonna keep fishing. I'm gonna turn the GoPro off and we're just gonna fish. Maybe we're gonna swim a little bit, so. All right, guys, I've already caught 10. Brian caught one big honker of a fish. And Soraya's caught 3 and Tiff's caught 1.
Caught 11.
Oh, I've caught 11.
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, you've caught 1, but only because you've been eating. You need to be fishing. I'm just kidding.
Hey,
I know, you guys, these guys were swimming a little while ago. So. All right, guys, here's the cast. Been nailing them pretty fast.
Oh, my God, you're
All right, hooked up, guys. Just a little dinky one, probably the smallest one all day. Check that out, you guys. All right, guys, I've already caught 16 today. They've all been rainbow trout, though. We're trying to catch a grayling and nothing yet, but I haven't heard of anybody catching a grayling here yet so far, except for Brian last week. So I know that there's brook trout in here because he caught a brook trout also last week. So all we've caught is rainbow trout. Hold that line up, honey, with all the fish, that stringer. It's all the fish we've caught. Not all of them, we've let a lot go. We've caught all those on power bait. Worms haven't been working.
Just play in the water.
Yeah, just play over there in the shallower end.
Well, we were telling Brian if he wants to go fish where I was fishing, that he can. Because I'm done fishing for a minute. I'm just going to play with her.
Are you?
Uh-huh.
Keep that spot over there for swimming.
What's that?
Keep that spot over there for swimming if you want.
That's what I was saying.
Oh my gosh.
Are you sure?
Gosh, there's a spider.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just step on it.
Where?
All right, you guys, hooked up again. Number 17.
Wait, don't forget about this. This guy's all ending.
Just a little one, little teeny one. Let this one go. Yeah, it's too small. We're gonna let this one go. All right, hooked up, guys. Number 18. All right, you guys, we got 13 fish that we're keeping. We're gonna go for our limit, which is 4 per person. There's 4 of us here, so that's 16 fish. We got 3 more fish to go, so let's catch these last 3 fish and then we're gonna call it a trip. She said it's swimming time forever. Wife's over there, she cast it in the tree. Oh, here we go, guys. All right, hooked up. Now here's number 20. 20 or 21, now I lost my count. Either way, we've caught many fish today. So all we need is 3 more, and then we're leaving. It's a little one too, don't want it, but we've been here for a little while today, so we're gonna keep it. All right, guys, two more fish. Here we go, guys. Hooked up. All right, you guys. So I think we just need one more fish and then we're gonna end our trip. This one feels decent. No, he's just a little one. He's just a fighter. Like I said, if they don't hit it, you just give it a little movement. Just let them know it's there. They'll see it swim down.
So you've let a lot go too.
Oh yeah. Yeah, we've caught quite a bit today.
You're probably averaging one for what, 10 minutes or 5 minutes? Or?
Probably, yeah. And this also works in streams really good because what will happen is you get heavier weight though when you're doing streams or rivers.
Yeah.
And your weight will sit on the bottom. If you get heavy enough weight that the current's not going to pull it to the side of the bank, then your weight's going to sit there and your bait, since you give it a tail like I showed you, then it'll sit there and swim back and forth in the stream and it looks like a little fish swimming.
The major mistakes probably are just too much cheese.
Yeah, a lot of people put on a lot and you don't need that much. It's unnecessary.
It's just a waste.
They think the bigger the hook, the bigger the bait, the bigger the fish. That's not always the case. Yeah, I really wonder why I'm not gonna bite.
Whenever you're showing someone how to fish, then they won't.
Yeah, of course, I'm showing you, so now it's not gonna.
Yeah, so you just do this and then they bite and then they won't want to. But I've seen you do it all for the last 30 minutes, just pulling them in.
Honey, we still got one more fish. So it's you and me, whoever catches it first. Or if we both hook up to one, it's the biggest one we keep. With that tail pointed up. No, you don't need to go way out there.
Boys, I think we're about to go.
What power box do you use? The garlic smelling one?
I use all of them actually. I like them all. To me, I don't really find that there's a big difference in the color. A lot of people claim, oh, orange works better here, but I was over there down at Table Fork, and that's where I caught the most fish I've ever caught in one day, and it was 60 fish. And my buddies kept saying, oh, it's because the power bait you're using, that's why I'm not catching any, because it's my power bait. So I gave him my power bait, and I says, give me yours, let me try it, and I just hooked up on his too. Yeah, it's just all the presentation.
Yeah.
It's all the presentation, but garlic, they do like that scent.
Yeah, but rainbow green, whatever.
You know. Yep, rainbow green, just really bright colors. All right, guys. I caught the last fish. You better reel in, honey, for they get yours.
And that looks like a good pole to a sensitive pole.
Oh yeah, real sensitive. Alright, there's the last one, guys, for our trip. Alright, you guys, this is the outro to our video for today. Hey, I want to give a big shout out to Eric. He subscribed to me. He's one of my followers, and I saw him here today, and he looked at my shirt and said, hey, I like your shirt. I said, thanks. He says, wait a minute, are you Levi? Hey, I know you. I follow you on YouTube. So I just want to give a big shout out to Eric. Thanks, brother. And anyways, you guys, we had a great time here. Hope you guys catch us on our next adventure. All right, you guys, have a good one.